Yeah. Kaká Gaming, the ones who brought you Smash NES 19.
Also bring you social media sites of Kaká Gaming.
A Facebook, a Twitter, and YouTube. Follow them. Now.
Make sure you check them out if you want to keep catching events like this. And make sure you check out Tokyo Otaku Mode.
Yo.
To really just... I keep saying otaku. It's otaku.
What are you saying?
Oh wow, they're just going in. Whatever.
Hello.
Well, yeah, man. Make sure you visit Tokyo Otaku Mode. You can probably
And while you're on that website, please tune in to this set right now.
Yeah,
happening
exactly.
Grands.
You can shop. You can shop for those great Figma's
and
Nintendo.
Multitasking in 2017. Get used to it. All right.
Maybe it's 2005 from.
No.
He's got Big D's tag right there.
Oh, you're right. I don't know why he does that. I don't know.
I don't actually know.
Maybe some meaning with the year. Anyway, to the game, though. Pretty even
more
right
important
now.
Parts.
Big D starting to get some stage control here.
Okay.
Interesting fair. These guys know each other so well.
It's so much fun to see. Like, Kathy, like, Big D's like,
these reads coming from miles away.
You're going to be right here.
I have a vision.
And, like, even if it does it, it's like, oh, my God.
But
it almost
knew. But you can tell he knew. Yeah.
It's no random F smash.
Exactly.
These guys.
He's very good at using that dash attack, too. More than most other Marios I've
seen. Oh, my God. The platform.
The platform's saving L.
Down throw fair? Not quite. Good DI.
I'm going for the world. Captain L using Pikachu's jab in a very good effect, just to get people off of him or push people wherever he wants them to be. Now he tries to have the mix-up, but...
Just get that beat.
That was like slight DI back. Yeah.
And it wasn't enough to get it, and then Big D with the up smash there to take the lead.
The classic Pikachu killer. Don't need pest control.
Wow, there.
Wow, no assist rage percent. Like these two have played so much, it's like, okay, I have 130 rage, 120 rage. They're at zero.
It's not going to work or something.
Up throw back air.
Yeah.
It's just like...
That's optimal at that point.
Oh,
Don't dunk him. No, don't
dunk him. Come on.
We're too different.
Dunk him.
I'm like, don't do it. Be nice.
Big D's.
And then Nick, you're just
showing,
like, do it.
Showing a little bit of respect here, but.
End him. Just end him. Oh, my gosh.
But, showing a little bit of restraint, but.
Oh, Fox?
Yeah, he's just.
I've never seen this.
No, but he's just really.
Is it more of like a dejected, like, desperate?
He's reaching, I think, but also he might grab onto something.
So is Green Fox the perfect counter pick color? what's going on here?
To red Mario?
Yeah. Oh, this is actually really cool.
Merry
we're
Christmas.
Seeing Beetle Fox, so I'm actually really good.
Yeah, you're right. Wow.
This is really interesting. I don't know how this is going to really work out with...
Like, honestly, I might kind of like that because Fox's air mobility is not the best.
Yeah.
So
I'm lucky losing it, man. It's so crisp. Anyway, go ahead.
So the fact that tilt stick, you know, and aerials, it won't affect him anywhere near as much. And like, he's good at that with Pikachu.
Yeah.
But I feel like Big D is.
I'm sorry.
It's so good. It's so good, though. Like, I know he's getting beat
he's
up,
getting,
but it's so good.
It's oh my god.
Microspacing will always be one of my favorite things. And he's just like, oh, perfect pivot.
Bro, we wave
crouching.
Dashing up in here. Let's go. Double shine up smash. Or shine double wave dash up smash.
Yo, does that work on Mario?
Maybe.
Yeah, we're about to find out. Let's go.
Yo, Shine was actually good in this game.
Yeah.
That'd be so cool.
I mean, you can give him cloud with it.
It's like a good edge guarding tool.
It's good
but I mean,
cloud,
like a neutral option, you know? That'd be so cool. But anyway, back to the latest game that Sakurai has blessed us with, Smash 4. Right now, L trying to make something happen.
And sliding back and not letting Big D back on stage, but he's got a little bit to catch up on.
Yeah, this is interesting. We're not
he's
any,
just
like,
kind of poking him.
We're not seeing any like dares or nares that time. We're just looking.
Uh-oh, Rage Mario. Ooh, Rage Mario putting on a good 50% here.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like he's kind of dealing too much at this point. I don't know. I'm a fan, but like,
doesn't
it's
even
not
care. Just
really
like whatever.
Working.
I don't care about your jabs.
Yeah.
No, like I said, like he might have grabbed onto something,
there's
but
like no up
he was either. Definitely he was definitely reaching.
Yeah, and I'm not seeing any up tilt whatsoever. Like, does Zito mess with like your tilt stuff, right? So it's
yeah,
it's
so
a
it's,
special
it's,
move. So he.
That was
but you can do that though.
That was real good.
You can do that though. So this is a very I don't want to say
he doesn't. He doesn't win the game, but like he did a lot of cool stuff.
He did cool stuff,
but
I don't
like,
know if
I
it's
don't,
really practical.
Don't really recommend Fox. I don't. I think he was definitely reaching. He doesn't know what to do. Like,
is that a two stock?
No, he got
that super crisp down smash. What am I saying?
Oh my gosh.
Wait, what? So,
just like.
Oh my gosh. And he's going back to Pikachu.
Yeah, a smart move. Like, he knows that, like, he probably can't do it with Pikachu, but. It's his best shot here.
Yeah, he's got to come up with something quick, though. This is his last chance, potentially.
Absolutely, yeah.
Can't mess up any more times.
It could just be the quick 3-0 and if you win in Smash Nest, but with these combos, L's not going to give up quite so quickly.
Like the out canceled downer.
Vicky yeah. Feeling himself a little bit with his up smashes. Yeah. It's putting him into a bad situation here.
Yeah,
and Tessinel gets the punishes.
This Beedo style definitely can get you more. I do really like it for this character.
Absolutely. Feels built for him.
Yeah. Oh, this combo, bro. This is just
like,
Mario
like,
things, man.
It took three combos to get Mario to 106, and it took one to get Pikachu
one
to, like,
string,
100,
man.
Like, 74. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh, that's a
that's
kill.
That's it, dog. That's it. Yeah.
Save for Cloud.
Yeah.
Cloud slides a lot for Perfect Pivot, but enough about Perfect Pivot. We got to talk about this game where Captain L is taking quite the advantage here.
John, Perfect Pivot is way to a game four. Oh, man. And
Big D with the call out, but.
I like Captain L's choice to stay on stage. Oh, okay.
Stay grounded.
To stay grounded, I was
yeah,
going to say. Like, or like on the stage in the center of it.
He's forward a little bit there.
Maybe kind of, yeah.
Big D only a down throw away from wrapping this back up.
Oh, and that ended,
just
not
like
a
that.
Safe
just
not
like
a safe
that.
Fair, not a safe.
But.
And this is where things can get really frustrating. Big D's starting to turn it up. You can tell.
Oh, yeah.
With his option choice.
The next down throw with Mario is dangerous, if not deadly.
Almost telling Captain L he's giving you enough time to pick your options, not anymore.
Okay.
And go in.
But Captain L actually sniffing out a lot of these options, but.
B?
Oh, wow. He wanted to keep the control and just kind of just chased him down. Big D's a. Like, I feel like there's two schools of Mario, whether or not you should up B or whether or not you shouldn't. It's like
you want that quick damage,
or those like weird setups, those weird like
yeah,
like you're in total control, like aerial tech.
Oh, that's
almost.
It, yo!
Wow.
That jab was pushing him
wow,
to get sweet spot. Can't tell if
serious
or
not happy, but
can't tell if serious or like I don't know, man.
He's just frustrated with himself. I'm sure him and Big D play all the time, and they love each other. Like,
yeah,
they probably drove down here together. I imagine.
They gotta be. All right, well.
So that wraps up.
Quick 30 and a handshake for Big D. Smash Nest
19. Well, that matchup, the tournament. Anyway, we've got interviews coming up.
Ooh.
Apparently, yeah. Like, I don't know. I'm assuming we did it last time.
My dude.
Do you want it? Do you want to do it?
You can do it.
I did one last time. If you want to do it.
You sure? Oh, it's been real.
Deuces. Well, no, are you sure? You
it's okay. No, it's okay. You're
okay,
good.
Sure.
You're
all right.
Good.
And then so, and that was solid M2.
Yeet. All right.
And up here we got M2 destroying everything, and we've got Big D coming up. We'll probably have to adjust this thing a little bit. There. You can adjust that as much as you want. So, we've got the winner of Smash Nest 19 here, Big D. How do you feel? Like beat up a lot of Pikachu.
I hope Lan's all right.
Yeah, like you two are good friends, right?
We are good friends.
And he's probably
know.
Just frustrated with himself.
He's probably frustrated. Like the last time we played, it was game five. You know, set two. It was like a lot of stakes. You know, he's probably in his head, right? It's probably
absolutely.
Like, damn, you know, this shouldn't be happening. But you know, we all have our good days and bad days, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You know, he's going game five for Zach. Doesn't usually happen.
Mm-hmm.
So you know.
Yeah, Zach did a really good show. Why do you think he went Fox? Has he tried that before on you?
If he has, probably way back. But this is more—it's a recent thing. I know he's been developing with his roommates. I don't think he should have went Fox.
No.
It wasn't ready. If you're going to do that, do a game one, not game two.
Yeah, exactly. It puts you in too much of a disadvantage. But besides that, like, your play was really amazing. It's clear how much you two have played, how much you two have probably met in grand finals in BC, like, tons and tons of times, like, knowing the spacing and the combos for each other.
Playing for years, even Brawl.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Even developing some new stuff, like, it pivots back a lot. I'm sure a lot of, like, Oregon's not used to seeing that as much. See ya. Thank you. Like, not as much seeing that. I know, like, Silent Rain maybe struggled, like, what do I do, right?
Yeah, like, it was clear to me watching that match that him and you have fought so much that it's like, oh, another Mario, and this Mario doesn't know how to fight Pikachu. Like,
yeah, no, he's really good. He's, when you fight Mario, you have to stuff him out. You have to figure out where he's going to go, and you got to put a hitbox there that
and it's like, how does
you in too much danger.
How does Pikachu do that? And then Pikachu can't really edgeguard Mario?
He's got the down air on the up B, but it's not as good.
Yeah, you can't really gimp Mario. It's very difficult for him. So.
Yeah, but Lana's developed all this stuff.
Oh,
I know when he played Anti, he got him to switch off Mario. I don't mean to say this really? Is like tooting my own horn, but like, it's more of like, it's proud that me and him have developed that matchup too.
Oh, no, like, you're probably, like, if you fought Esam, I wouldn't like,
he would probably go like Mewtwo or Samus.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
So, yeah, there's that. And yeah, I think I was playing well today.
Oh, yeah. You were definitely on fire on that.
Normally, like, when I fight Fed, it's like a lot. It is closer. Like, it was the first two games really closer.
Yeah. Well, you said a good DD in that one.
Yeah.
You went DD against Fed versus Rafa's
every time. DD. Every time I play Fed, it's always a DD. I always went DD. It's always, like, hella close. So I was like, maybe if I go Mario, you know, maybe this will be, like, easier than DD.
And it just, like, never is. You're like, okay,
it was,
DD.
Like, pretty much just as hard. So I'm like, all right, I'm just going to go DD. Yeah. At least I know, like, that's guaranteed to win. We're not guaranteed, but rather, like,
you know,
it's
like,
been in the past.
Yeah, it's like, who has a DDD down here, you know? Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah, it's definitely really good to have in the pocket.
Yeah, exactly.
And but yeah, it was a fun tournament. Enjoyed coming down here. I got to see Jimmy again. That was great.
Yeah, I'm glad that all you come down.
Yeah,
I'd love to see you more, especially like Zach, who did amazing this turn. Like, top three was all BC.
It was actually two players I want to fight from Oregon are Silent Rain and Justice.
Oh, I really bet. Yeah.
I haven't gotten the opportunity to play them, and like my whole region, they do have a lot of Mario practice. But myself, I play Mario. I am the Mario. So I don't have that same practice, though. But I do love the Mario Ditto. So I think it'd be really,
really?
Interesting
okay.
for us to play.
Okay.
He seems better at, like, different matchups. Like, he looked better versus Luigi, and I've seen him play Sonic. He
oh, yeah,
like,
you can tell that in any matchups that, like, are in Washington or Oregon, he's pretty used to. But it's a lot of these, like, unfamiliar BC matchups that are really taking him.
I do think I have, like, a lot of, like, for example, like, Sheik and, like, Ryu and, like, all these. I think I do have him there.
Okay.
Diddy Kong.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, definitely the matchups, like, he's better at.
Oh, yeah.
So it's true, and I haven't played Justice. I played him in doubles. Kind of, he's really good with his jabs and spot dodges.
He's like the one of the most fun people to fight because like he's so cerebral of how he plays.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, you're just like every
like
time you get an advantage, you're like, oh, this is.
But you see, when cerebral players play me, right? They try and get in here. They can't get in here.
Yeah.
They think they can
no,
get in
I,
here.
No, I remember a long time ago asking like, oh, how do you play D&D? And you're like, I don't know, I just play him.
I mean, it does come from experience, right?
Like, yeah, just like.
You know, other characters, they have a dash attack. They have a.
You and Jimmy play like very similarly, where it's more about the feel of stuff. Like you feel someone's going to do something. You're not really like have a certain game plan. You just like you flesh it out in the moment.
I mean, that's good. I think one thing that I do like is, you know, the field goes far, right? But if you hit a wall, right, then when your field fails, then you do need to think of it.
Oh, absolutely.
And that's like, all right, why is this? If you have an understanding of like why things work, why things don't work, mm-hmm. then you can like adjust accordingly.
Oh yeah, you have to adapt to you have to like keep true to your style. I feel to really keep going, but you have to pull in stuff from every location you can to make yourself a better player.
Oh yeah,
and it's clear like number one in BC. Like the last time we fought, you destroyed me. So
I'm actually really good at that matchup. Like,
do you normally go Falcon against Cloud or?
Oh, I do normally go Falcon versus Cloud.
Okay. I was wondering if that was just a.
But I am. I try and, like, be good, like, all match with all my characters, because...
Oh, yeah.
Heck, I'll discuss it now. Do you play, like, just the Cloud? Do you have, like, characters?
Oh, yeah, I mostly just play Cloud.
All right.
I try and, like, you know, mix up who I play a little bit, but I mostly play Cloud in tournament.
Well, it's like, here's the deal. If you're trying to pick up a character for, like, a certain character or a certain somebody, right?
Uh-huh.
You know, and, like, great, that works out. You know, you do this after the double blind. You fail a double blind, they beat you. You counterpick them, they beat them, right? But now you're stuck... Like, oh, shoot, no, now they're going to counterpick me.
Yeah.
But, like, if you get it to the point where your secondaries are just that much better than, like, their secondaries,
mm-hmm.
you probably know that matchup better. You're probably going to be better at it, more comfortable at it. Just beat them there.
Yeah, it's you have to.
They're the one making the snake situation.
If you're going to pick a secondary, you really kind of have to go into it. Like, you should either not pick a secondary or you really have to focus on them.
Oh, yeah.
Like, almost like a co-main at times, but.
And that's not quite consistency that we see. And here we go. I got some
the payouts.
Prize money. Oh, I got a, let's say a nice 100, 200. Oh, I got 300. I got more than 300.
Nice.
That's pretty good.
Good stuff.
That's good. That's you know, in Canadian, it's like you can buy a house. No, you can't buy a house. Not in Vancouver. Not with that.
You can buy like a good meal.
Yeah.
You can buy a nice meal. Yeah.
Fun tournament. Always love coming out here.
Yeah, it's nice to see you out here, and I'm glad you came out. Good stuff.
Thank you. All right. I have peace out. And they're all waiting for me.
And I'm gonna sign out too. This is what's up.